Mutations from different sources are mixed and passed on to later generations, leading to genetic variation. Certain genetic compositions are suitable for certain environments, thus allowing them to thrive. But they may be unsuitable for other environments, resulting in themselves being eliminated. The idea is about whether the genes match with the environment. The environment may be a natural one. Hummingbirds that have longer beaks have advantages over those that have shorter ones. It's also impractical to have beaks that are too long. Those that survive have beaks that are just long enough to reach into most flowers for nectar. The environment may also be an artificial one. Humans decide what kinds of dogs get to live with them. Among humans, certain physical traits like lighter skin, eye, and hair colors are sexually favored over others. Group selection is a mechanism in which evolution acts on the group instead of on the individual. Why would individuals contribute or sacrifice altruistically for a group? When two groups compete against one another, altruistic individuals acting together ensures group survival. After external enemies have been eliminated, competition between individuals purges the weaker individuals within the group. Variation describes the differences within a group. Too wide a variation causes a group to split, resulting in diversity, which describes differences between groups. Variance is a statistical term that describes the spread of a variation. Variation means that there are people who fit into their environment and perform their roles well, and there are people who don't. Successes and failures are part and parcel of evolution. Epigenomes are chemical compounds that attach to DNA and direct actions such as enabling or disabling genes. Identical twins have the same DNA. Any difference between them is due to their environment and not genetics. Studies show that many differences are reflected in their epigenome differences, which increase with age. It is obvious that humans evolve during their lifetime. Environments expose a person to pressures that lead to changes in their epigenome. Evolution can be seen everywhere in everything that evolves. Humans produce stuff that is similar to one another and, at the same time, different from one another. Stuff evolves from version 1 till the birth of new stuff with a new version 1. How human societies evolve falls under societal evolution.